Right. That was pretty quick. I haven't had a crash yet, so that's cool. Yeah, so welcome back. This is Rick the Spartan, and we're back on Dishonored the Definitive Edition PS4. Go for the clean hands and ghost, hopefully. Fingers crossed. I've not been caught or killed anyone yet, so yeah. Yeah, we came out this door last time, just from the flooded district after we spared down, unfortunately. And we're gonna start a conversation with this poor individual woman here. So yeah, let's go straight into it, shall we? Hello.
Please, no. Oh, it's you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed. Except for Samuel. He seemed sure you'd survive. I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore. But I'll bet he's still out there. Looking for you, is my guess. At first, Pendleton said it was time for our bonus. Havoc stood behind them, and at the signal, he shot them each in the back of the head. Just like the target drills he used to. Lydia barely had time to scream. I would be dead too. Except Wallace told me I wouldn't be getting anything. Pendleton kept apologizing, saying that no one could ever know about the things they'd done. Martin was drinking and seemed sad. The Admiral was about to shoot Callista. Then he mumbled something about owing her uncle, Captain Kurnow, a debt. They said it was time for Sokolov, and went off to his cage. I don't know what happened after that. Emily was there when the killing started. Poor child. I hope she hid her eyes. The Admiral said that Martin was right. I guess they talked about it. And they started to worry they'd get executed for all that they'd done, going after the Lord Regent and his allies. I suppose it's why they've poisoned you, too. I thought Lydia would squeal on me at the end. She just told Havelock to screw himself. And died. Lydia's the only one who ever showed me any kindness. I don't think the Admiral actually knew I existed. I can hide here for as long as it takes. Seems that no one is safe when a man is that close to a prize like the throne.
There we go. Seems like they killed everyone. Son of a bitch. That's quite sad actually, because they didn't deserve to die. None of them did. They were just doing their job. Kind of gives you a bomb on that, doesn't it? It's proper. Yeah, this game really shocked me. I must admit, I don't normally get surprised in game stories because they're predictable, but this one. Yeah, I didn't see it coming. It's still now, it sort of pisses me off that they were that greedy, you know. But I guess that's what she said though, isn't it, when you're that close to the throne. Anyway.
What a day, huh? Great party tonight. I was only a kid at the last coronation, if we even make it to tonight. Will you look at this mess?
Relax. One of the officers said he was dead. Run in the river. If you ask me, he's long gone. Threw the mask in the river, left town.
That's what a rational person would do. Not this guy. You have to understand the criminal mind. I hear they had to hide the Cauldron girl from him the whole time they were working with him. I heard they locked him in a cage and only let him out at night.
Criminal mind, huh? So what's he doing now?
Waiting. He's probably watching us right now. With that crazy mask on. Creeping closer and closer, ever closer, until...
Cut it out. What's so impressive about Corvo, anyway? Who's he got up against? A couple of high overseers, a couple of noblemen? He could never stand up to men with our training.
Well, now I do hope he shows up. I want to see you run crying for the cover of the tall boys out there.
Like you were, the other night.
What was I supposed to do, stand there and get hit by rocks?
They were just kids.
They were a gang. I hope Lord Regent Havelock sends the tall boys in to level the place. It's gonna be a new era.
Having a 10-year-old on the throne isn't gonna cure the plague.
High Overseer Martin says it. He says we were cursed when the Empress died by Corvo's black magic. And the rats are never gonna leave until we had a real Cauldron back. He says the outsider follows Corvo around.
There's some curse on this city, that's for sure. I'm still trying to forget working in the flooded district.
Don't remind me. Before we go, I'm gonna stash a few bottles of wine from the cellar. Take them out here with us.
Just make sure Corvo's not hiding down there first. Maybe you're right about that guy.
So, I don't know why they didn't just tell him Hiram Burrows is the one who hid down. He had evidence and everything. Why pin it on Corvo? Pretty stupid, really. Yeah, I do hate this conversation. Yeah, this is probably the most annoying part in the game for me. Getting past this fucking stilt walking cunt here. He spots you no matter where you hide. Before, I used to hide on top of this lamppost, and then I tried to get up it. I don't think he can get up there, no, and he spotted me. So, yeah, I don't know how someone would do it without powers, I really don't. If you knock no one out and stuff like that, then I applaud them if you can, but that...
That's nice.
Yeah, that guy's a dick. I hate him. You can't hide from him. Make sure they come back. Yeah, it's normally better just to wing it. But like, if you have stop time, you can just stop time and blink all the way over to this tower and go inside. That's where Callista is. And she told you where the people have gone to and stuff.
That's just ridiculous.
Stupid rats. Dice.
Plague. Elixir. Bunch of crap.
It really is hard to get past this guy. See, you can't go now because you need to go where he's going at the moment. But you can always go inside the window that's over here. I guess.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to save, so I apologize. Oh, shit. I didn't save in the flooded district, did I? Ah, oh, crap. Oh, poo. How far does Niblick reach? Not further enough.
Seen any more big rat swarms?
You're such a chopper.
I'm not a chopper. Okay, get ready. Oh, son of a bitch, what are you going out with all?
Attention Dunwall citizens, Hiram Burrows, formerly the Lord
Regent,
has confessed to heinous crimes against the people of Dunwall. He shall be confined to the Coldridge prison until the proper authorities decide his sentence.
That was Havelock. I recognize that slimy voice anyway. It's kind of piss taking anyway, I just stabbed you in the back. Oh yeah, don't go out there. Yeah, we will need that blueprint for later on, so if you can, best to pick it up first. Yeah, I do apologize for using this vision, but, you know, screw you. I don't care. Screw you guys. Nah, I love you all, I really do. Yeah, this guy is so fucking evil. Yeah, there are so many guards. It's crazy. Yeah, they're trying to get into Pierre's workshop.
Callista, it's Corvo.
They killed everyone, Corvo. They killed everyone to cover it all up. Then they took Emily with them and they left. I couldn't do anything to protect her. Please find her. Make her safe. All his talk of being an honorable military man, but Havelock will use Emily like a puppet to his own advantage. Something changed in the Admiral as soon as the Lord Regent died. It had been building up. Martin was acting strange, going quiet if any of us were near, whispering late into the night with Havelock and Pendleton while you were out doing the real work. I think they realized they were one step away from holding the same position the Lord Regent had, and worried they'd be held accountable for what they did here, as the Loyalists. They would have killed me too, but Havelock spared me. Out of respect for my uncle, I believe. Please, talk to Samuel and the others. Someone must know where they're going. Find Emily. She's suffered through so much, and she's got no one else on her side except you. Samuel set this here in case you returned. You can use it to call him. He said he'd come quickly. Hopefully there's a place he can dock where the watch won't...
Callista, fret not. I believe there's still hope for Emily in Dunwall. I believe Corvo... I don't believe Corvo is gone. I'll be searching the river for him, but if you catch wind of him, shoot up a flare using the launcher at place in Emily's tower, and I'll make my way back as quickly as I can. Keep his tower locked and take care of yourself. Emily's going to need you when this is over. Ah, Samuel.
The city watch is everywhere out there. But I don't even care if they find me anymore. I saw Samuel on the river earlier. I'm sure he'll take you to Emily. One last trip, I expect. I had one job. Take care of Emily. I tried as best I could. Go after Emily. I'll be fine. I really can't believe they did this, but if they were willing to kill to get what they wanted, I guess they'd be willing to do anything. Havelock is a power-hungry bastard. I can't stand the thought of her in his dirty hands. He knew you wouldn't let him use her. I guess the Admiral had a change of heart. And maybe Martin helped him along. Pendleton just went with them. That coward.
Seems to me like Martin was the perpetrator in this. Okay, let's not pull that just yet. We've got some other things to do first. Don't go to Emily just yet.
Refreshing to converse with someone on my own.
Couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the Academy was a crime against natural philosophy itself.
Which you might have pointed out at the time. But it's pointless to hold a grudge. I want to ask you...
About the elixir, yes. And I need to discuss your tonic. Why have you not tried the homeopathic solution?
And where am I to find the subjects? I can't recruit from prisons as you do. But it's forced me to work with another agent derived from...
The river crests, yes. I'd guessed as much. But I think our approaches may reinforce each other. This is what we've been lacking thus far.
Well, I knew it was too good to be true. Seems the conspiracy tried to use old Piero for their own gain and discard him. But they have erred and delivered to me an ally almost as brilliant as myself. Old Sokolov and I will hole up here until we can blast the ruffians outside and make for the Academy.
Yeah. So, Piero was the one who rescued Sokolov then.
No, stupid guy.
Take all their food?
Corvo!
What up, fellas?
See that you still breathe. The city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system. Merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started. Return the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may never